thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. All the success in New England over the last few decades, and this crowd has never been more enthusiastic. A moment ago, the Pats emerged from their locker room. They are set as they'll square off with the Jacksonville Jaguars. This is Leonard Fournette, and he'll get this one up to the 26. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. But Fournette was really bottled up last week against the Bills. 21 carries, 57 yards. At front seven, though, they were strong.
They really were, and it's tough to run against what Buffalo presented. But if you just keep giving Leonard Fournette carries, things tend to work out. Remember earlier in the season against the Pittsburgh Steelers, who they were playing in the playoffs, he had 181 yards. This guy went over 1,000 yards in just 13 games as a rookie. Leonard Fournette's an absolute force and is only going to get better.
The yardage total, second highest by a Jags rookie.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
The gun on third down, Bortles. And that's complete to Lewis. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. They'll run it now out of the gun. Some extra space following the display of power. Down just inside the 45. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
And Leonard Fournette impressing there with that run. It's hard to believe that no Jacksonville Jaguar has broken 1,000 yards since Maurice Jones-Drew in 2011. I think Leonard Fournette could be that guy.
Even with the ankle injury last year at LSU, still averaged 6.5 yards per carry.
And absolutely intimidated opposing defenses. A lot of guys simply didn't want to tackle him.
And this will be incomplete. The running back, Leonard Fournette, his intended receiver, and it's third and short.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. Now Bortles. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Now the offense lining up first and 10. They go back to the ground now with Fournette. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
2nd down following the run. Shotgun now for Bortles. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
8th play of this opening drive coming up. This is 3rd down. Working from the gun, it's Bortles. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, They remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And it is good. Oh, that one looked to be in trouble the whole way, but it does get over the bar. And the Jaguars grab a 3-0 lead. So our initial drive here this afternoon results in three. I'm not sure that was a statement necessarily, but getting points on the road, never a bad thing.
No question about it, Brandon. You had a crowd that was all fired up during pregame introductions, yet you're able to quiet them just a little bit by taking the early lead.
Now after the made field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. Here's Matthew Slater to return it. Oh, and now he bowls him over. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. Carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. A gain of three, second down.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop the jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
They try again with Lewis. And now running right through it. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. But at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Throwing is Brady on third down. Looking for Gronkowski, and he's got him complete. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. 18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down. When you give up points on the opening drive, in this case a field goal, you'd hate to go three and out. They avoid that.
They do, and it's also walking that fine line mentally, too, as a coach, isn't it? Because you want to emphasize to your team exactly what you said. All right, we gave up a field goal. Let's go back and at least equal that, guys. But if we don't, you don't want them to feel like it's the end of the world either. Nice that they were able to pick up the first down there, help them relax a little bit.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
What I loved about meeting with these coaches before the game is we didn't even have to ask any questions. They told us that they were going to be aggressive and push the ball downfield. They weren't successful on that play, but look for them to try it again later.
Gives this one to Lewis, and he'll get this down only to about the 46. Only a yard of the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Third down, Brady. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. On fourth down on now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is. At the 6-yard line. And out Now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Again, it's Fournette. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. Give him 2 yards on that play. And just like that, it's third down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Throwing his Bortles. They set up the screen to Ivory. And he'll have the first down as he's up to about the 18. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
They go play action here on first down. And he is out of bounds, getting it just shy of the 35. 16 yards that time on the pickup for the Jags and a first down. That's a matchup maybe they go back to their outer third of the field as this game continues.
Yeah, I think back to my high school coach, John Ford. He used to say when we got big plays early in a game or good plays, he'd always say, foul it away, lad, foul it away, because he'd want to come back to it later in a key situation. They may come back to this one a little more often than that.
Didn't he say laddie or did he say lad?
Yeah, it just depended on what he was feeling at the
okay.
moment.
Okay, I thought that was the guy you told me about that used to say laddie a lot.
Laddie? When you heard laddie, he was usually in a pretty good mood. Lad? Eh. Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Bortles going to run the draw with Fournette. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Throwing his Bortles on third down. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there. That brings up fourth. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
Nortman on to kick as he sends it away. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. On the slant, he gets it to Gronkowski. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16.
Remember, the Patriots did not have him last year when they won the Super Bowl. He was out for the playoffs, but he is healthy and ready to go this year.
And isn't that one of the more remarkable things, that they won a Super Bowl without having that weapon in their lineup? Well, guess what? He was back this year. Big time season, 69 catches, over 1,000 yards, 8 touchdowns, his 5th All-Pro selection. Yeah, they're really happy to have him. They don't want to try and win a Super Bowl twice without Rob Gronkowski in the lineup, and it appears they will not have to.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Again, it's Lewis, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That'll go as a loss of 5, and they're going to face a third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number 2. They're looking at a 3rd and 6 here to start things out. Brady going to throw. This is White on the screen. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. Instead of the running back in New England, sometimes they like to call them the passing backs. They get them the ball in different ways, don't they?
They certainly do. Think about the ones they've had in recent vintage. You're talking about Kevin Faulk, Danny Woodhead, Shane Vereen. James White could have been the MVP in the Super Bowl if it wasn't for a certain quarterback that was on the field that day.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And down to the 44, 5 yards that time.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Now Brady throwing on second down. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Brady connecting with Cooks for the Patriot first down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. Give him 3 on the play, and it's a second down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Second down, here's Brady. Over the middle, that's caught by Hogan. And he'll go down at the 28. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
The offense on third down tonight, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at 3rd and a few inches. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Officially a gain of just 1 yard there, but they do convert on 3rd and inches.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much.
First carry now for Rex Burkhead. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
throw on second down. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll be third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
New England on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Laundry on the field. This is going to be a false start on the offense.
Sometimes you have to slow things down a little bit when things get heated. The cadence has to be slow and deliberate at times to make sure your team's ready to go.
New England on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Shotgun now for Brady. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line.
Partner, I don't care how long he plays. Anytime there's a fumble involving Tom Brady.
You think the Raiders are involved?
You think the Raiders are involved, you think it's snowing, and immediately you hear the words, Tuck Rule.
Oh, Fournette loses it. It's out, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
He'll set up the screen to Fournette, and he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Give him 6 on the screen, but now it's 3rd down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
It's Chris Ivory, and he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It's a 5-yard pickup, but spotted a few chain lengths short of the first, so a little bit of decision time here coming up on 4th down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Here's Brad Nordman now on for his 2nd punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first 2 drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now, and I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try to move the football.
To throw is Brady. Right side, that's complete to Gronkowski. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Now Lewis. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Only a gain of 1 yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the 2nd half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a 1st down, pick it up, and keep moving.
This is Lewis. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
To throw on 2nd down, Brady. And And that'll be incomplete. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after. And it's third down.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. To throw on third down, Brady. And he's got a man open. That's Allen. And brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. 18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down.
They really love to get him into one-on-one opportunities, and this is one way. Work him out of the slot and create a mismatch. Who's going to cover him? Corner, safety, linebacker? He's got a way to beat all of those positions.
On play action, now Brady. And pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Second down now after the incompletion. They run. This is Lewis. And he's brought down. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Patriot first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
And the eighth play on this drive coming up. On first and 10, here's Brady. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
So that'll back them up 5. Seven yards to go on second down. From the gun, it's Brady. Amendola catching it left side. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, big hit. The Patriots pick up the first down. Brady to Amendola.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on.
Tight is right. Tight is right. 20.
Again, it's Brady.
And caught by Hogan for a Patriot touchdown. Chris Hogan, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Pats able to cash in for 6.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Hey, looking forward.
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
Kowski now out to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here.
And I would say they went 3 and out last time, but actually they didn't even get to 3 and out. Still a strange decision to us here in the booth.
Yeah, let's hope they don't go 1 and out, but maybe, possibly, let's try and think with them here. Try to play field position maybe, turn the ball over, put it in the hands of their defense. Who knows?
You're a nice man. They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette across the 30 to the 31-yard line. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
There we go now. Blue 45.
They'll run it again with Fournette. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. As they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. The Jaguars on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be 3rd and 6.
Here we go. 3, 39.
From the gun, it's Bortles. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up 4th down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Here's Brad Nordman now as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. This is taken at about the 14. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Patriots take over. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Start things on first down with Deion Lewis. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Set.
So we've reached halftime here at Gillette Stadium with the Patriots on top. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
No gain on the play there. Second down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Up past the 30 to the 31.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. New England on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This will be 3rd and 5. Operating from the gun, Brady. And that is incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Allen on to punt as he gets this one away. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And it'll be Jaguar football as they take over deep in their own territory. Fake to Fournette. Now it's Bortles to throw. Looking and finding Allen Hurns. And he's going to be out of bounds at the 39. A really nice gain of 25 yards. First down, Bortles. He finds Hurns left side. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. First down, Jacksonville. The passing game looking sharp on this drive for the Jags. Play fake, Bortles. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for James O'Shaughnessy as tight end. And that'll bring up second down. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
They fake the handoff. Now Bortles. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Kyle Van Noy leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of 6. Following the sack, 3rd and long for Bortles and the Jags.
Here we go now.
The play fake to Ivory. Now Bortles. And he's got it to Hearns. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And a big loss here as he's taken down.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Now Bortles throwing on second down, and he gets it down to the 32. The reception good for 7. It's third down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Now Bortles. And he's got Rome. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. First down and goal to go from the 7. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And here now it's second and goal, ball on the 7-yard line. They stop short, down at the 1. Had the great move, but couldn't get it all the way home. A nice run there as he picks up 6. It's going to be third and goal now. And the seemingly endless drive continues. They come out here in the eye. Now third down and goal from the 1. And a nice move will yield nothing as he stopped behind the line. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
Another stop on third down, and this defense still hasn't allowed a touchdown to this point.
So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. This a chip shot, a 20-yarder. And Lambeau will put this one through, and they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. A decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged 3 out of it, but they do inch a bit closer.
Yeah, still lots of time to go in this one. Take the points, move on, and let your defense try to get the ball back.
Now after the made field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. This is fielded at the goal line. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. So the Patriots coming out now. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll start off with a give to Lewis. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but a guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Second down following the run. Play action, now it's Brady. He's letting it fly for... Well, this is taken in, it's complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
Brady gonna throw. It's caught out wide, Amendola. And all the way in. Touchdown. Patriots add 6 to their lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Jags offense now gets set and heads back onto the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that. Super toe.
A good pickup there, a 22. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
A good pick up there, 26 yards. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it, because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. On play action, it's Bortles. Oh no, he lost the football. And this is gonna kick out of bounds. Boy, a fortunate bouncer too there. They'll keep possession back inside the 10-yard line.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
Working from the gun, it's Bortles. And he's got it. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Nice gain of 8 that time, and it's second and goal.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Second and goal from the one. They'll toss it to Fournette. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great play there. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Jaguars move back within a couple of the lead.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had two previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
Here's Lambeau out to kick this one away. Now Deion Lewis to return. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
They start the drive on the ground with Lewis. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Brandon, is all about pace and tempo now for them. They've got the advantage, so I'm going to put in musical terms for you. You don't want to go prestissimo. That's too quick, too lively, right? But you also don't want to slow it down too much. You don't want to go lento. What you really want to be is moderato. Nice and even, nice and steady, get those gains, and close out the game.
I think that chicken parm from last night's gone to your head. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see. Now Brady. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. He'll wind up being stopped for no gain, and it'll lead to a fourth down. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. This is taken at the 23. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On first and 10, here's Bortles. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. Second down, here's Fournette. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And that's going to lead to a third down. And of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late. From the gun on third down, Bortles. And some room to work. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. A gain of 8 and a first down. Time starting to run out here in the fourth. This defense just trying to keep the offense off the board and preserve this potential victory. First down carry, and an alley to run, and he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville at a first down. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now here's a whistle as flags come in, and we'll check out the call. The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
Here we go on first and 15. After the penalty, it's Fournette. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it a second down. He's back to throw. But he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Following the sack, third and long for Bortles and the Jags. Back to throw. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. Now whistles blow, and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. And the eighth play on this drive coming up.
There we go now. Green, 39.
On first and goal, they'll try the option left. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. He'll look to throw. This is caught. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Ben Koyak from 10 yards out. And the Jaguars have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
A score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Here's Lambeau out to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the
opportunity? And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Counting down toward a minute to go in this football game. Back to throw. Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And they'll get him down here at the 23. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. They'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. This defense so strong all afternoon long. Well executed again there.
This is a group that really functions well off of each other. No matter what the assignment, the other person fills in the exact proper spot. They've made it very, very hard for them to find open places to throw the football.
Now Brady, gotta have this one. This is caught, it's Cooks. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow. So many practices that we've watched over time where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there.
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? Brady to throw. And this is caught, and it's a three-point game. So that effort gives him a three-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy, because that's all you care about, not getting beat at this stage. At least give your team a fighting chance.
Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock, a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. He'll check this one off to Fournette. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. Out comes the Jaguar offense now as they get set to take over. What do you do here down like this in this situation? Do you maybe just pick something out of the playbook you haven't called in a while, or you call it a day?
You can do that, or you pick something that's a staple for you and should work better and try and execute that on the way out the door and maybe get back to base and feel a little bit better as you end a ball game that's been a frustrating one for you.
Man, we'll see if they go back to base. Bortles to throw. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Now Bortles. And that's complete to Lewis. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as he'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. So here we go, first and 10 now. Back to throw, Bortles. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. Marquise Lee, the intended target, and it's second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. To throw is Bortles. And he's got some space here. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. One final try now for Bortles. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. Well, Charles, a pretty exhilarating finish to the end of this ball game. At the end, the Hail Mary prayers, though, they went unanswered. Could have won it, but couldn't get it done.
Almost felt schoolyard or playground, didn't it? Yeah, you remember when you called that play? Everybody just go long and try and find someone open. They gave it a shot, but unable to successfully complete it.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Patriots winners here at home, as we say so long from Foxborough.